In this beautiful surah, Surah Luqman, we have in Surah Ar-Rum before it, the trilogy of actually Al-Ankabut, Ar-Rum and Luqman. It's a trilogy. The three of them, and As-Sajda comes after that. They all start with Alif Lam Mim. And they are surahs of meditation and reflection. They invite the rational to reflect and meditate. And we find in these surahs a repetition of these pairs of divine names. Many, many pairs of divine names you find in the surahs. We saw today Al-Latif Al-Khabir, Al-Ghani Al-Hamid, Al-Aziz Al-Hakim, Al-Alim Al-Qadir. Let us stop by Al-Latif Al-Khabir, the pair of the name Al-Latif Al-Khabir. Al-Latif means the subtle, means the latafa, basically. Latafa means to, it's the opposite of kathafa. It means it goes without noise. It doesn't make any noise, it's latif. We say the breeze is latif. Soft. We say the sound is latif. It's very thin and like whispering. We say this body is latif, slim and small. We say the size of this book is latif. It's a, this book is, the size is latif, it's not like a big, thick book, it's a small book. There is a word that many of you know, we call it al-wird al-latif. And there is no name latif in it. So, but it's not wird al-latif, it's al-wird al-latif. It is, basically, it means the short word, the small word. The small word, the small collection basically of adhkar, because there is al-wird al-kabir, which would take you more than an hour to recite it. And that one, this one is like a summary, latif. Subhanallah, calling Allah latif is a is shocking in the beginning. For those who were used to see Allah in the world of, or who were used to, not to see, to conceive Allah in the world of objects, in the world of phenomena. For those who used to worship gods in the world of the phenomena, so all their هذا أكبر هذا أكبر هذا ربي هذا أكبر هذا ربي هذا أكبر. They would worship the big animals, they would worship the big stars, the big phenomena. They would compare the divine to these big phenomena, calling Allah Latif. Subhanallah, subtle, soft. Is shocking in the beginning. Also for the minds who are used to see or to think of God as difficult, king of anger.
Zeus.
Calling Allah Latif. Latif. Say, my friend is Latif. It's like soft.
Yeah.
So, This is a name that was celebrated particularly by the Sufis and by our ancestors, and they would insist on this name because Al-Latif is the one who very subtle, has very subtle methods, goes deep and deep and deep, and there is nothing that could stop the Latif. So the strength of Allah and His Lutf. الله لطيف بعباده يرزق من يشاء وهو القوي العزيز. The strength and the لطف. It's a teaching for us as well that the real strength is not in rigidity. The real strength is in being لطيف. Out of all the names, it was chosen to summarize what we call the names of realization at the station of Baqa. After a person would go through the spiritual journey and go through what we call at-takhalli, detachment from all the bad qualities, emptying oneself from oneself. When comes the station or the stage of illuminating oneself now and tahalli, dressing up and putting the akhlaq of Allah, putting the qualities of Allah, they said the quality of all the qualities is Al-Latif. That's why in our dhikr we end with it after Allah, Allah, la ilaha illallah, ya Latif, ya Latif, ya Latif, ya Allah. We're calling on that quality in us. It is a quality that is jami'a li kulli al-kamalat. عباد الرحمن الذين يمشون على الأرض هونا. And that's the quality of the Khalifa. He needs to be Latif. He needs to be Latif bil Khalq. He needs to be Latif with the Khalq. He needs to be Latif. We read in Surah Luqman, all the message that Luqman is giving to his son is basically, you can summarize it as in the word Talattaf. Be Latif. Talattaf. Make yourself small. Make yourself unseen. Make yourself unnoticeable. Don't take too much space. Don't make much noise. Not go with the flow, but somehow also go with the flow. Not in the negative way, but go with the flow. With the flow of God, with the divine flow, with the flow of the time. Be Latif like the fish in the ocean. Don't stand against the wave like that, it will break you. They counted the words of the Quran and they found that the center of the Quran is the word وليتلطف, the middle, the heart, the center word of the Quran is the command وليتلطف. When the people of the Kahf, you know, Surah Al-Kahf is in the middle of the Quran, and the word of Surah Al-Kahf that comes just the center, word number something. There are a certain number of words in the Quran, 6,000 something, and then that word is like the right in the middle is what? وليتلطف عشيب. Balance, the balance, middle way, middle path. That's the middle path, the balance, وليتلطف. When the people of the Kahf are telling giving an advice to their brother when he was coming out of the calf. The calf is the symbol of the fana. The calf is the symbol of mutu qabla an tamutu, of death before death. So after going through the death before death, which is called al-fana in the spiritual mystical language of Islam that the Sufis have developed, after going through that fana, when you resurrect and you go to the baqa, and now you have to go back to the society, go to the Medina now, go and search for food for us and go and mingle with people. The command is وَلْيَتَلَطَّفْ. If you want to go and mingle with people now, be latif, don't be jabbar, don't be ghalif, don't be latif. Make yourself small, make yourself unseen if you can, make yourself unnoticeable, be latif. Be gentle, be kind. All of that is latif. And it is a name that is very, very, very loved by the mu'min, very close to the heart, because that's what we are yearning for as a human beings going through harshness and going through hard times and going through bad times. We are always yearning for that person who is latif, who comes to us and soothes our pain, and that soft touch. So that's why people, when they have a musiba, they say ya latif. Latif is the name of the alchemy as well. Inna Rabbi latifun lima yasha, says Sayyidina Yusuf, when he's telling the story, when he's giving the narrative at the end of the story, after suffering, after being thrown in the well, after being sold as a slave, after being thrown in the jail, after going through all that suffering, phenomenal suffering, spectacular life, that suffering, after going through all of that, how things changed after. And actually there was no change, it was one fact leading to another. The best storyteller, the best writer of the scenario of his life, latifun lima yasha. One step leading to another, one step leading to another. يَجْعَلُ اللَّهُ مِنْ بَعْدِ عُسْرٍ يُسْرًا. After difficulty comes ease. So people who are going through difficulties, they love that name, Ya Latif. It's very close from our hearts. The name Latif here is paired with Al-Khabir. Al-Khabir is the one who knows everything, the expert of everything, but also the one who tells the story of everything. So yet it is Latif, yet it is Khabir. So there is always a contrast. When there is a pair of names, there is a contrast. It's Latif, but it is telling everything. It says everything. Imagine if I tell you this voice is very, 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 very Latif. It's very, very, very thin, yet it is reaching everyone. Khabir means reaching everyone. That's what Khabir is. So the story that the Divine says, it reaches every ear, it reaches every mind, it reaches every heart, it reaches Khabir. Khabir means it reaches, Khabir means it encompasses everything, and it reaches everything. Khabir, Kabir, there is a similarity. Great. Magnificent, encompassing, reaching Latif Khabir. And again, the name Khabir paired with the name Latif, it gives power and it emphasizes this quality that the bleeding person and the injured person needs and yearns for. From a place of pain, you want someone who is truly Khabir. You want a doctor, you want a nurse, you want a friend who really knows what you are going through, who really understands, who's not going to ask you annoying questions, who's just going to look at your face, look at your eyes, touch your pulse, and I got it. You're much pain. Don't need to tell me the full story, I get it. I've been there before, or I know it, an expert. When you are really hurt, you want to go to that doctor who is Khabir. You want that friend who is Khabir. You want that counselor who is Khabir, who knows what he's talking about, who knows the sickness, who knows the difficulty that you are going through. And in the same time, you want him to be Latif. If he is Khabir and Mutajabbar, would cringe, can't. But you want a doctor that is Khabir, that knows all the sicknesses and knows all the cures, but in the same time, Latif. He has a subtle way of curing, a subtle way of treating. Soft. Al-Latif al-Khabir. So these two names together, they remind us of the function of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, al-Bari', al-Shafi, the healer. Because indeed, Allah is a curer and the healer of humanity. And he's healing the humanity with much lutf and much knowledge. He knows their reactions, where they are going. So from that place of pain, let us call for this name, Ya Latif. Ya Khabir. You know, there is that traditional dhikr, Ya Latifan bi khalqih, Ya Aliman bi khalqih, Ya Khabiran bi khalqih. Ultuf bina, Ya Latif, Ya Alim, Ya Khabir. From that place, let us sing and chant and call these names, Al-Latif, Al-Khabir, and also for us and for our brothers and sisters and for this whole humanity that is bleeding. Ya Latif, Ya Khabir, Ya يا لطيف يا خبير يا الله يا لطيف يا خبير يا يا خبير يا
لطيف يا خبير يا الله، يا لطيف يا خبير يا الله، يا لطيف يا خبير يا الله، يا لطيف يا خبير يا الله، يا لطيف يا خبير يا لطيف يا خبير يا الله، 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 يا لطيف يا خبير يا خبير يا الله، يا لطيف يا خبير يا الله، يا لطيف يا خبير يا خبير يا الله، يا لطيف يا خبير يا الله، يا لطيف يا خبير يا الله، يا لطيفا بخلقه يا عليما بخلقه يا خبيرا بخلقه، قلت بنا يا عليم ويا لطيف ويا خبير.
Beloved Lord, Almighty God, through the rays of the sun, through the waves of the air, through the all-pervading life and space, purify and revivify me, and I pray, heal my body, heart, and so,
Ameen.
Through the latif rays of the sun, through the latif waves of the air, through the latif all-pervading life and space, purify and revivify me, and I pray, heal my body, heart, and soul. You are the one who knows all the sicknesses and knows all the cures. Ya Latif wa Ya Khabir, Ya Latif wa Ya Khabir, يا لطيف ويا خبير، يا لطيف ويا خبير، يا لطيف ويا خبير، يا الله يا أرحم الراحمين، يا أرحم الراحمين، يا أرحم الراحمين، يا رب العالمين. Said before, the names of Allah are appointments between us and Allah. That's where we meet Allah. That's where we meet the Divine in the Mahsus, in the world of immanence, in the world of khalq, in the world of senses. That's where we meet Him. It's the horizon. The Asma al-Husna, it's the horizon that is mending, or that is bringing,
meeting,
merging, if you want, or bringing together the earth, the land, and the sky. It's the horizon. They are very relevant to our life. Each name is relevant to a pain you are going through. They are relevant. They are mediums. They are there to help us connect with the Divine. Otherwise, it will be an abstract that we cannot relate to. They are names for the Salat. They are names for Dua. They are names for Salat. To establish a connection, to draw nearer. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us a due tawfiq. Ameen ya arhamar rahimin rabbil alameen. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala ala Sayyidina Muhammad. Alhamdulillah.